Hello, Orchid friends. Welcome back to my channel. Wherever you are, I hope you're having a great day, staying healthy, and staying safe. Today, I have a Phalaenopsis orchid, and it's a cross between yellow chocolate and Joy Sarah Lady. I've had this orchid for a couple years now. When I first purchased it, it was two orchids in a pot. And when I bought this from the nursery, I had already known, they already told me that it's two plants in a community pot, essentially. One of them didn't make it, and this is the only one that that made it, that grew to eventually bloom for us. Initially, it was in a moss medium. And when the other one was showing signs of stress, I knew I had to repot them. So I basically got rid of the moss and transferred them into an organic setup. The other one didn't make it, like I said, but this one took off since I repotted it. This orchid is quite interesting because I really like its color combination. Specifically, if you look at the edge, the very edge of the flower, the petals, the sepals, you see that yellow edge, yellow outline, and then the petals, the top right, top left petals seems to have more red to it, and then the rest is kind of that yellow dark orange and yellow in the background for the sepals. It doesn't have a strong fragrance. It does have something, but it's not very strong. But I'm hoping that the fragrance will intensify or get stronger as this orchid gets older. I have another orchid that kind of did this. It wasn't fragrant the first 2 years, and then it started to produce fragrance as it got older, and that was my Cow Dot Twinkle. Because when I first purchased it, I thought my Cow Dot Twinkle was a defect, because most people's Cow Dot Twinkle orchids are fragrant, and mine wasn't. And after the third bloom, I think, it started to have fragrance, and you know, so that may have to do with the age of the orchid, because the care didn't change. But back to this orchid, it only gave me a couple blooms this time, but I'm still thankful. It's just this orchid's first bloom. So I have high hopes for next bloom cycle. Hopefully it will continue to grow larger and give me more blooms. I do want to kind of look at the root production or the root growth to decide if I want to up-pot this orchid just yet. But if it doesn't have the tendency to grow too many aerial roots, right now you see kind of two growing out of the, you know, going upwards since the repot. If it doesn't do this too much, I may be able to get away with keeping this orchid in this cup, in this media mix for another year, maybe 2 years. In terms of care, I do give this orchid 25% or quarter strength fertilizer every week, and then at the end of the month, I would only use just pure water to soak this orchid really well to make sure there is no salt buildup, and then we can also wash away any dead tissue, any whatever that you don't need in the medium. And in terms of water amount, quarter cup of water usually is more than plenty, and because this is a smaller cup and smaller orchid, quarter cup of water typically would have excess water on day 4, day 5, and sometimes I would decide to just dump out the excess water so that way it would get another 2 days of no water at the bottom, because I still want this orchid to have that wet dry cycle completion within a week, 7 days essentially. I also think that this orchid is interesting because initially I thought it was putting out a new growth, a basal cakey. If you go back to the beginning of this video, you'll see. But I was wrong. It actually continued to grow grow and become a flower spike. So the way that this orchid put out flower spike is very different, and I'm gonna actually keep an eye on this one for its next bloom cycle and see if it actually does the same thing. And now here is just a comparison photos and a short video clip after. So today's orchid is the one on the left. The one on the right is also a yellow chocolate cross, but it's a cross between yellow chocolate and phoenix. Yes, I got these two orchid types from the same orchid nursery, Joseph Wu's orchid, and for the other ones also came in two in the same community cup, community pot. They survived, but the one on the left, one of them survived. So I have a total of three. And coming up, you'll see a video clip, and it's just a video to give you a sense of what they look like when they were in bloom together. I will do a separate video on the two on the sides. That's the cross between yellow chocolate and phoenix. The one today, you know, have more red on the petals, and then the two on the sides have more red on the bottom two sepals, but they all have that yellow edge on all the sepals and petals, which I find very interesting, very nice to look at. And the color combination is that really festive, auspicious red / orange and yellow, which is a very likable color combination in at least the Chinese culture, right? Red, yellow, orange, these are auspicious colors. So when they were in bloom, especially when I was taking this video, it was actually, it gave me a very festive, very auspicious feel. They all have some fragrance, like I said earlier, not super strong just yet, but I'm hoping that the fragrance will become stronger as they age. But overall, I think these are good finds. They were not expensive at all. And it's not the typical kinds of look that you'll get from regular grocery store phalaenopsis. Oh, by the way, and they're also just miniature small orchids. They're not gonna be too big, which I love. This is all I have for you today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to get more orchid-related videos from my channel, please subscribe and turn on the notification. I want to wish you happy growing, and I will talk to you in my next video. Ciao!